What's up, y'all? Welcome to the stream. I'm making a game called Songbringer. I'm over a year into making it. And, today's goal... What's up, Pedro? Welcome! Today's goal is to... I'm going to focus on some things. I'm still focusing on things I learned from Indie Cup, from watching people play in person. And I want to make a gate around the home screen. That's today's most important goal. So let me show you what that would entail. Put the player at the very beginning. So, yeah, also, what's up, J2? What's up, you guys? So, one of the most painful things about watching people play the game was when I saw people get totally stuck without the sword. You know, like, people would get to this screen, they would wander off this way without the sword, running around the whole... And there's just so much overworld you can get lost in, and if you don't have the sword, you're totally confused, you're totally lost, and you're clueless. You're basically just helpless. Scottish Pizza, what's up? Sit in the car, right on. Oh, you saw Star Wars, don't tell me anything. I can't wait to see that. I got a joint ready for that already. What's up, Arcane? Yeah, I finished the controller. Everything's looking good, man. Here in the... Oh, that's what I want to show you guys this too. I'm hoping this is more intuitive now. So the red, like, you know, this red color aligns with the D button up there that I've got it bound to. So if I want to go and switch that, you know, it aligns all... These are all color-coded. So I want to see if this actually makes more intuitive sense to people, how you would go and remap your buttons and stuff, or if it doesn't. Darth Vader is Luke's father. What's up, Live Studios? You like the colors? That's cool. Good. I'm glad the colors are cool. I guess you guys are probably going to have to try playing this to, you know, once the alpha update comes out later this month, to see whether this is more intuitive or not. But I hope it is. Another thing I added was you can tell it's a little more higher quality. It fades in the menu, or the gear menu here. Also, I fixed the top hat thing finally, Pedro. So if I throw my top hat and then pause the game, it stops the top hat noise. Also, it auto pauses, so if I just sit here for like 60 seconds, it'll auto pause the game. Oh, Twitch stopped working? Oh, I said, don't tell me anything about Star Wars. I can't wait to see it, and I have a joint ready for it. I'm so stoked. Less distracting? Good. Right. Oh, no! So, once again, I'm still, it didn't resume, but isn't that better than it was? Right? I mean, yeah, I could go try and figure out how to get it to resume as well, but this is so far, you know, I'd rather just have it at least. Same thing when you go to this menu, too. It stops the top hat noise. Because the top hat noise is a temporary thing anyway, so I'm just going to say that for now. Oh, good. I'm glad. It's amazing. What I was saying was, when I was watching people play Indie Cup, especially one of my friends came to Indie Cup and he was playing the game, and I was so painful to watch him miss the sword. Like, he didn't go in this cave at the beginning, and he ran around the overworld for a good 20 minutes, you know, without the sword. And I'm like, I had to tell him something. I'm like, dude, you know there's more to this game, right? You can get a sword. So... What I decided to do, I've been trying to balance not having too many tutorials and yet making the game, you know, friendly for people that are in today's modern age, you know. So I come to a kind of a compromise, and that's in permadeath mode, it will act like it does right now. There's going to be no gating whatsoever. But in regular mode, it will actually put a sword gate, which is one of these growback tiles right here. It'll put one of those on the edges of stuff, like right here. So you can only wander around the overworld for like the first 5 or 6 screens that are right around the home screen before you get stopped by some brambles, and you'll need the sword to get past that. So worst case scenario, a person that's playing in regular mode will only have to wander around 6 screens or so before they realize that, oh, there's got to be something I can get, there's some kind of thing I can find, and then they finally go, oh, I'll go in this cave, and they get the sword. So I am open to thoughts there. Please enter pre-sword here. Yeah, that's the crash site. What is the Red Gradient map? Oh, Red Gradient on the map? What was that? Oh, whoa, look at that. That's a bug too. The HUD disappeared. What's the Red Gradient? What was that? You think about the same solution? Good. Cool. Oh, the red dot is the indicator for level 1. Okay, so before I get to gating around the home screen, I want to do 2 quick things first, and that's to show more clearly the player on the map, and I can do that by just making the indicator for the current room bigger. So I think it's map indicator. Yeah, map indicator. Wow, that was really fast. Find that. All right, here's the old map indicator. And then I can make them all somewhat transparent in the code. Yeah, dialogue. That's a good thought. Oh, the red gradient on the mini map when you're in the game. Oh, let me check. Red gradient on the mini map. Oh, that's nothing. That's just lighting. So right, I got it so it uses the game's lighting, like the shader for the whole screen. It uses that same shader on the map right now to try and give it more of an integral look. And also when you go into night mode, it really helps to have the shader on the HUD as well. So I think it's a little bit of a bug because I think what it's doing right now is it's showing you the orange of these lights right here. I don't know why, but it is. It's showing them. Oh, I just realized why, because the map is I'm running on a separate layer, a separate camera. So yeah, I think what's going on is it's showing the red, the orange of the of that. All right, pizza. See you, man. Okay, and when it draws the map. And it shows the current player's position. Is this it? Current room? I think it might be. So the point of this is to make it way clearer where you are. I didn't repack the textures. Dang. Why didn't you repack the textures, man? Oh, don't tell me I did. Oh, I did all slices? Damn. Raw sheets. Okay, repack the textures. Man, why do I always have problems with this? Gotta turn this back on. Oh, Hammerspoon's not even loaded. Reload. Maybe it just wasn't even loaded. Okay, come on. Yeah, some dialogue. Yeah. Yeah, that's a good suggestion. So one of the biggest things I want in this game is the feeling of openness. That's what makes Zelda 1 so distinct in my mind versus all the other Zelda games. Zelda 3 is the next installment in the series where they have Zelda 2 was the side scroller one. Zelda 3 was the next one where in Zelda 3 you get stuck at the beginning. You're in more of in tutorial mode. You have to go play that one little level to get through things. So it's less open. You don't have as much choice as a player. So a dialogue is a good way to do it, like, because it's not blocking the player or anything. This cave looks like a dangerous place. I should go there for sure. Yeah, I mean, I guess it could put a little bit of dialogue at the end of the first dialogue anyways. Does that look okay now? That's a little too bright. So this is more like 64. Oh, now that's interesting. Some critters that carry the sword in there. Yeah. This is definitely not the current room. Where's the blinking indicator for where you... HUD current room 2. Okay. Yeah, it is this. Oh, this blink action might be what's up. Okay. Rather than messing with it anymore, I'm just gonna change the art. Oh, or Jib goes in there? Interesting. What's up, Tugboa? You want to learn computer programming? I suggest the internet. I suggest checking out YouTube videos. And I also suggest getting an engine right now. Go get Game Maker. Play around with Game Maker. Okay, that's a little too transparent. What's up, Blood? How you doing, man? Maybe it should have the edges as well. Oh man, I'm sorry to hear that. My condolences. Dead life's good, man. Yeah, I just had my aunt pass away last week. That's why I wasn't streaming this last weekend. So yeah, I hear you, man. That's pretty good. So I think it's clear where your home screen is now, or where you are on the map. Okay, cool. That's one thing done. Okay. Good. Let's cross that off. Okay, one other quick thing before I get to these gates is I don't want people to be able to quickly XXX past the press buttons to here to get past through when you die. No, not a bad week, not at all. Oh, you mean bad week for people staying alive? I hear you there. Okay. So yeah, if I die, why isn't he dying? Oh. So if I die and press a button really quickly, you see, you don't even get to see the screen before it comes back. So it needs like at least a second in the phase when you're seeing when it's phase death. Seems to be the topic of the week, huh? Phase death, come on. There. Okay, so it needs to wait a little bit. What's this delay? Yeah, so that's why. It's because this thing is active for a whole second before it even displays its final stuff. So it needs. Oh, here we go. Elapsed start time. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on, let's do delay. Let's add 1 second to the delay. See if that is enough of a difference. You need big text with "you died." Yeah, it's there. Your hero's not alive anymore. It's there. It's there. That all that text is already there. It's just that I'm quickly pressing buttons to get so it skips all that. Oh, damn. There. Okay, yeah, that 1 second made all the difference. In fact, let's make it a little longer. So once again, I'm dying and I'm pressing any button really, really fast. Just da-da-da-da-da-da. So it's simulating a player, in attack mode. You're playing the game, you're swinging the sword really fast, you're fighting a whole bunch of enemies, you die, you're still pressing buttons. And that can easily get you to quickly, get past the screen too fast. So now it doesn't. It waits for a good fade in as well. Beautiful. I like that. Okay, so that's two little quick changes that are done. And now we'll move on to the point of today. Gating around the home screen, but only in regular mode. Yes, exactly. The player needs to feel all that pain. So that's done. Let's also check in so far. Okay. So let's go to the overworld scene. for this one. All right, so here we are, World Seed Wizard. I'm gonna make it so there's gates around, right around the home screen. So, the gates will be like this. Here's the home screen, this pink area right here. Here's the home screen. There'll be a gate right here going in this direction. There'll be a gate right here, gate right there, here, here, and here. So I'll keep the player within those first six areas. But once again, this is only in regular mode. Permadeath players, speedrunners will not ever have to worry about this. And really, the whole point of being able to have the choice of whether you get the whole point of these gates is of the whole reason I never wanted to put these gates in was that I wanted the player to be able to not get the sword, and that's okay. If the player is hardcore enough that they want to play this game without even getting the sword, they're probably going to be playing in permadeath mode, anyways, and. If they really didn't want to, if a player was ambitious enough, they could actually play in regular mode, save up enough coins to get some bombs, buy the bombs, and those bombs could get them past these gates as well. So there's ways of that hardcore players can do it in either mode. Yeah, Boogie. What's up? What's up, Pizza? Welcome back, man. Okay, so back to the maze generator. After it's done filling in the maze, it's going to look at the current world's mode. You just got pizza? Sweet. I haven't had pizza in too long. Way too long. Okay, right about here is where we want to go and place gates around the home screen. You ate a bunch of pizza? Slick slices? Oh, I'm getting hungrier. Hungry. So if this is the permadeath mode, I forget how I check that. All right, so if we got save game key mode, it's permadeath. We're gonna do, or it's not permadeath. How about just regular, or not equal to permadeath. What am I working on right now? I'm working on making it so the player is kept within a certain area around the home screen if they don't have the sword. And this is only in regular mode. In permadeath mode, there's no need to do this because permadeath players are hardcore. Dude, whoa. You had to keep eating until... So X is start X minus 1. X is less than or equal to start X plus 1. Y is start Y. Y is less than or equal to start Y plus 1. Dig from there to dinner time. I like Boogie's life rule. Okay, so on the home screen itself, we continue. We don't need to do that screen. But other screens we do, and we need to... So we need to go to the west. Oh, in fact, this should probably happen before the gate paths are centered. Tuna? Whoa. Tuna pizza? Alright, so if X is... We need a west gate if X is less than X, start X. And we have an opening that way, so this has opening. Is it has opening? Oh yeah, has opening. Great. Talking about X, Y, and the direction is K west. Make sure that's the method I wanted to use. How about it? DXD, this is open. XYD, and this is valid pause DX, and it's open DX in the reverse direction. Yeah, this is a good method. Good job for coding that, me. West gate. Okay, so we're gonna add a gate right here. This set gate. I don't think I have a set. Oh, I do have a set gate mode. Yes. Yes. Set a gate right here in the direction K west. Gate type. Okay, gate one. Okay, I think that's might be all we need. So we got a west gate, an east gate if X is greater than start X. And a north gate. That's all we need. Just three types of gates. If Y is greater than start Y. All right, let's see if that works. You have constantly 10 liters available? Whoa. I know, ounces. Totally. Okay, so we got a gate to the west right there, gate rest there. It looks like we might have a gate north as well on the those two corner ones. Yeah, let's play this, see if that worked. Is ounces a volume? Isn't it weight? Isn't, I don't know. All right, great. Player would be blocked if they didn't have the sword here. Oh, there's fluid ounces and... Man, something I never even knew. What is that? Oh. There's some bushes right here. Cool. Good. This is working so far. I was concerned about this one. Yeah, the fans. I was concerned about this one because it had two gates, and that worked out fine. So both the gates can be possible. We should have some gates back on this screen, too. Magic hat, yep. No, it's not actually magic. It's technology. There's these little homing drones that are inside it. Homing drones just return. Alright, good. We've got plenty of gating going on. The gates could look more interesting, I would think. But at least they're fulfilling their function. Nice. Okay, so let's test this out. Let's do a brand new game. Well, we won't even get the sword. We'll run around and make sure it works, and then also make sure it works in permadeath mode, that there's no gate. So I think I've got this set up right. Let's go. Let's not skip the menu, and we'll try this out. Oh no, you can't keep a keg at home. I hear ya. I hear ya. I can't just, you know, I can't just smoke weed whenever I want to either. Life at home is tough. Okay, so here we go. Start a brand new game, regular mode. Call this one catnip. You know. All right, starts me here. I forgot. I want to start the player not here. Yeah, that's another thing. From watching people play the game in person at Indie Cup, it was too confusing for people to start here on Songbringer. Songbringer has four different choices, just like the home screen does in Zelda 1 and this game's home screen on the overworld. There's four choices. You go up, west, north. On the home screen, you've got the cave as well. That's your fourth choice. So this is confusing to start here. So I'm actually going to start the game with the cutscene of you flying off of the ship on your bike. And you crash the ship. You don't even have the cup at first either. Let me fix that right now, actually. Oh, should I have done Katniss? Just tell the wife that it's cleaner. The beer, the produced beer is bonus. Oh, it's air cleaner. I get it. What's up, Valezan? So world, I did this last time. Here we go. This is the star pause, ship Z. I don't want it to be the ship Z anymore. I want it to be the home pause. Whoa, 8%? Dang. It's early morning for you, Vailzan? Crazy. Go to Czech Republic, step one. It's true. I've been there. I love the Czech Republic. I love all the underground bars. They're so cool. Yeah, that should work. Okay, should work. It's always funny to say that. Here we go. Let's delete that one. Oh, it's Australia. What's up? Cool. These do sleep late. Belgian beer, also awesome. Okay, we're starting in regular mode. Let's do the word poopy again. It's already Friday in Scotland, but it's like. Wait, but Australia. Wait, Australia, you're. Is it Friday there? Definitely the poopy world. Okay, so I'm gonna simulate playing as someone who has no clue. I'm just gonna skip the cave. Here we are, running around the world. Oh, I'm stuck. I can't get past here. What should I do? I'll go explore somewhere else. It's Friday there. Oh, right. Nice. I must say, I love your country. Oh, these are weird. These are aligned all weird. No wonder these. Kind of funny. Yeah, I love your country. Love your people. Been there a few times and had a great time every time I'm in Australia. Have you tried coffee yet? No. Okay, the next world I try will be coffee. Don't tell Marza that Australia exists. Yeah, because he's gonna talk about time travel and stuff. We're gonna be like, what? Really? Good. Okay, we are totally. It appears that we are perfectly stuck. Without the sword. Let's check this one last area. The last poopy world I played was Booger Man on Genesis. What's Booger Man? Is that that's such a sweet name. All right, cool. There, we're totally stuck. Just for the hell of it, let's get the sword and make sure the sword can get past these things. Of course it can. Oh yeah, that's great. Finally got this working now too, so you know, people need to see this. It's like, okay, use it with the F button. Go to your inventory with the E button. Very nice reminder to have that there. And no, I'm stuck in here. Oh no. This guy doesn't stand a chance today. Whoa. Yeah, got you. Don't come to Canada. I love Canada too. Some of our best trips are in Canada. We always go to Vancouver area, see our friends, go to Whistler and stuff. Yeah. There's a lot of places I want to go. I've never been to Scotland. Never been to Ireland or anywhere in the UK, really. Okay, that worked. Confirmed. Let's play permadeath mode and make sure that there's no gates in permadeath mode. Yeah, right? You like Ireland? How is it? Yeah. You're moving to Canada? Nice. That guy was behind the tree. He was hiding. He's totally ready to just jump out. Okay, new game. Permadeath mode. There should be no gates. We're gonna try the world coffee. This has never been tried. To my knowledge. But not coffee. Coffee. Canada's a 2D world, right? You like America? Yeah? Where'd you go? It's such a big place here. Some places here I would think that most people would like, some people places I would think people wouldn't like. What's up with this? It feels like there's something missing. It's like the rocks up there feel like they need some bushes or something. Excellent. So in permadeath mode, we have no gates right here. Once again, no gates here. Good, good. It's a big platformer. Alright, great. So yeah, if I'm gonna play, if you're badass enough to play in permadeath mode, you should have the right to just not be blocked in the beginning. But if you're someone that chooses regular mode, or you're worried if you can even do this game, then yes, it's gonna help you along a little bit by keeping you in that area before you get the sword. Good. Oh man, this has resolved one of the biggest issues in the game so far that I've seen from watching people play.
What's up, baby?
Alright, it's pretty awesome. Canada. Yeah, Boogie. Yeah, I'm actually going to do that, where permadeath mode is going to be more like speedrun mode. In fact, I might even make it just called speedrun mode. But yeah, definitely. Basically, there's the hard mode, the speedrun mode, for people that are just ready to do that, and then there's regular mode for everyone else.3D is just a production of 4D. What a deep conversation we're having right now. Okay, so there. That's the code which places gates around the home screen. Very good. Yay. All right. Okay, let's see if we can fix one of these bugs here. The droid bats can fly off the screen, and so can wait a minute. Let's do something fun first. Let's add some new diamond types. I want to add some bigger diamond types. Right now, you can get one diamond or you can get five diamonds, but it's really fun to have bigger diamonds, like 10 diamonds and 20 diamonds. You have to use HTML5 for an interview? Yes, you could definitely say that. I'm not your friend, buddy. That's funny. All right. Items, constants. So we got diamond 5. Let's do diamond 10. Diamond 20. And then the rest of them, the bigger diamond caches are unique. So anything above 20 is something that the game records that you've already picked it up. It's like secret. I'm not your friend, amigo. Yeah.
Do you ever stop to think how important Canada is to the world? Right now, I would like all students of Canadian descent in this school to stand up. Just look at all these fine Canadians in your school.
It's Canada. South Park. Really? There's only 10 possible dimensions? Oh, thanks for reposting that. How to imagine the 10th dimension? Well, I'm really going to check this out later on. Even the 4th dimension is hard to understand. Wait, is this the joke? It's not a joke, is it? This is definitely going on my...
We start with a point.
List. Death by black hole? Uh-oh. It's homework time! Oh, it's a book. Oh, by Neil deGrasse Tyson? When I imagine dimensions, I start with just 10. Okay, so to get this set up further, we need... in gear component right now. It's the wrong place for all this, but anyways. Diamond 5, diamond 10, diamond 20. All right, let's get things drawn. Looks like here they are. Let's select the layer automatically. The universe in a nutshell, yeah? Oh, this one's the diamond icon, and this one's the diamond. Oh. So this is... this is like 3 layers? Wow. 3 layers to create a diamond oil. Okay, we'll create the next diamond one, diamond 10. And diamond 20.
We'd have to put something up on the internet that everyone would find fascinating.
Wait.
We'd have to put something up on the internet that everyone would find fascinating.
Okay. Diamond 10. Diamond 20. Let's do some slices. Oh, I don't think that one worked. Ah, there it is. Okay. New layer base slice. Gotta do it on the bottom one. Who did cut the diamonds and pin them in the grass? Just a mouse did it, huh? Yeah, a mouse would make sense. Mouses have lasers, right? Lasers can cut diamonds. It's gotta be the mouse. Is it a USB mouse? Or is it a PS2 mouse? Alright, yay, we're ready to do the coloring. Don't show slices. Okay, so diamond 20, I'm just gonna hue color it a little differently. What color should the 20 diamonds be, huh? Should we stick with the Zelda scheme? Red is 10? Let's do red first. Scottish Pizza, no, Songbringer does not have an Instagram, sorry. It does have Twitter and Tumblr and a lot of other ones, but I can only do so many social networks myself. If the first person I would hire, if I actually had money, would be a community manager, and I would just have them do all that stuff, but can't afford it, man. And besides, I'm having a good time learning how to do marketing on my own for this game. Oh, new substances harder than diamond? Like besides carbon nanotubes? It's asking me to rotate my device for this chat link. Oh, man. I'm really interested in this. Oh, wait. Creating Q carbon. Wow. Another thing I have to check out. Q carbon. It's the NY Times. Oh, this is a recent article. Wow. Where's Bucky Paper? Why don't we have Bucky Paper yet? Okay, I want this to look a little redder though. What? Zach Bell's game got ripped off? What are you talking? Which one? What's the one he's working on right now? Tell me more about this. That's horrible. Who ripped it off and why did they? Did they do a good job? Uh-oh. Safari quit unexpectedly. And we're still live streaming. Everything seems to be okay. Okay. That's what killed the stream many a day. Diamonds in the Poopy World. It does sound like a pop hit title. Ink. So what happened? Why did it, who ripped it off? Oh, he posted the source code and someone took it? But, oh, this game. Oh, the Ink game. Right, right. Ink's awesome. This is a super rad game. But it came out a while ago, right? Yeah, August 5th. So, right, I can see someone would want it. Someone would rip this off or whatever, but did they actually make money from the ripoff? You know what I mean? Like, did someone actually... Man. That sucks. Oh, it's called Overpaint. It's an Android app, huh? Scottish Pizza, it's a great question. Am I worried that someone will steal all my work? No, I'm not. You know how many days there are of development already? That someone would have to go and retype all of that code? There's over 40,000 lines of code in this game already. And I'm not done. There's going to be 10,000 more lines of code probably by the end of this project. Maybe more, maybe 20. This is a really hard game to rip off. If anything, people will try and rip it off after it's already out with the modding or whatever. Because it's going to be very mod-friendly. But in the end, if someone did try and take all of my source code, and someone actually did all that work to go and whatever, make the same game as Songbringer, but a little different. They would have to make it a little different. And, oh, overpainted? Basically, whenever you put something out there on the internet, there's always a chance that someone is going to take it for bad reasons, you know? But the thing is, when someone takes your creation that's not finished yet, they have to go try and finish it. So there's a lot of work they would have to do to finish something. And in that sense, their creation is going to grow into something a little different than my creation. So I'm not worried. It's like trees, you know? A tree plants a seed, the seed grows into a new tree. The new tree and the old tree are kind of alike, but if you think about it, they're totally different trees. One tree grows into this way and that way and this way and that way. Maybe one tree doesn't even grow as tall as the other. In the end, they're different trees, in my opinion. And then when it comes to people ripping off your game after it's already out or stealing your game, things like that, it's just going to happen anyway, so you can't really worry about it. Overpainted. It's a fantastic platformer game. Oh my god, these assholes. This guy's a dick. You can't just steal somebody's game like that. So, and exact, yeah, I see why Zach Bell is so pissed off, because it looks exactly like his game. Man, that's lame. I don't understand the true potential of Botfu. What do you mean? Oh, as if Botfu's recreating Songbringer? No, I'm not mad at anything. I was just wondering. Right? How? Besides Botfu, yeah. And you know what? The one last thing that I have on all of that is I've never actually showed all of the source code in my game. You know? That's just to keep a few of the cards to myself. I might show 80% of my source code, but that last 20% is pretty damn important. Wow, dude, good for you, Vlad. I never knew that. Wow. Okay, so back to making... That's kind of a red diamond. Yeah, that could work. And then let's do a hue shift for this one too. Layer reveal selection. Ah. Zach Bell actually said that he would never not post it, even if this happens. Whoa. Wow. That's pretty cool of him. That's right. So what color should the big diamond be? Green? I think green is what... I guess I'm totally going with Zelda memes right here. We also have a yellow diamond. This green is kind of nice. Okay, let's see what that looks like with those so far. Purple? Purple. Yeah, totally. If you do post all your source code. Yeah. Purple. Purple's pretty nice, but the other one's already purple. See, it's already kind of pinkish and purple. So, we'll do green for this one. Man. Just sucks hearing about that for Zach, dude. I really feel for him. It's really lame. Okay, we need to do this color as well. So this hue. Yeah, well, it's good attitude. Really good attitude to have. Okay, so now we just need to be able to place a couple of these items. In fact, let's instead of popping up regular diamonds when we go over grass, let's just do 10 diamonds or 20 diamonds. Area is going to need it to be able to create them. Yeah, totally. Yeah, it does. It does. And you know what? What I think, too, is also that the people that are going to rip off his game are probably, I think the chances of them making money with his game are a lot lower than him making money with his game. You know, he already put his game out. People already know that. People are going to buy it on Steam. Somebody rips it off and puts it on the App Store. Most games on the App Store don't make money, especially assholes that are just ripping off other people's stuff. Seriously, I almost want to flame that guy. Yeah, Velzin, totally. That's right. Pedro just sent me a link to that last night about colorblindness, so I need to think about that. Ah, good point, Boogie. Right. If a person's going to totally rip off another person's entire code base, they probably don't even know how to code. So, of course, it's going to suck. If they don't even know how to code, they probably don't know how to market either. And they don't know how to edit the game to make it any different anyways. Do I have any plans for after Songbringer? Nope, I can't think that far ahead. That's pretty far in the future. I have a hard time thinking about plans for, like, this weekend. Let's make sure this create item works. I think it will. Okay, so when the player tramples... I think the trample is here in move system. Yeah, trample. Let's make the trample emit a 10 diamond instead of a regular. Yeah, it does happen far too often. Yeah. Right. All right, we need a diamond. No diamonds? Oh, there's one. Yeah, red one. Oh, don't need to show me that. Did it count up? It didn't even give diamonds either. That's because we need a pickup item function. So gear system, pickup item needs to know what to do with these. You're lucky. Get your free app of the day right now. What's this right here? Oh, this is your new office? Whoa, dude, congrats. It's looking swanky, man. Nice. Wow. Very awesome. Whoa. Yeah, nice table. Sweet, man. Your office is your dorm room. My office is a closet. All right, let's put all these in the same one. Okay, Adam Diamond. Yeah. Yeah. That's gotta feel great, man. I'm sure it does. And the last thing is there's something where it get when you it counts up your diamonds. Oh, is this not covering all the cases? Is that what your problem is? Huh? Eh. That's probably it. Yeah. This life container is diamond stash. There it is, diamond stash. Get item price. Oh, I could just get it from the quantity. Or the price. That's probably better. Here it is. Game scene count diamonds. Why am I using one as the default? Because the item diamond is one. Yeah, it is cool. Yeah. What time is it? 4:40. Yeah, I'm Pacific time. You're gonna miss working from bed. Yeah, so putting the quantity in here is cool. That'll work. So diamonds are one, diamond five, diamond 10, 20. So now we just grab the quantity from the price. I think we don't need to play that anymore either. Let's see how this method works. Inject tea into my blood. Well, Well, good for you, dude. That's so great. Yeah, this will work. Skip the menu. Save me some time. Didn't count them up at all. Oh, that's why. Yeah. Sesame Enable. It's basically a revolution in, what do you call that? Not assistive devices, but what's that called? Nice. Nice blood. Okay, I like that, but I would like this first diamond noise to play as well. Nice. I didn't know you're the 100, you're 100% the developer. Whoa. Yeah, totally. It's totally worthy. Yeah, Vlad. Good job, man. Seriously. I'm sure you're probably gonna get thanked a lot doing what you're doing. Yeah, cool. Count those up. How do I get some of my sounds? Yeah, that's cool. I really respect everyone that records all of their own sounds, but I don't have the time to do that really. So I use a lot of sounds from freesound.org. And then I'll go and tweak them a lot. But also, I do generate my own sounds with Ableton Live and a combination of that and Massive, the Massive plugin. So I do a lot of like, that can give you some really sweet noises with Massive. And then Ableton Live is where I write my music and also use those kind of things. And then also, I use Bfixer. Bfixer is great. I'm not gonna run it though, because it makes crazy loud noises as I run it. Okay. Nice. The stupid Android UI. 100 diamond? There already are those. Yeah, Lime Studios. There's already diamond caches. So yeah, anything above 20 is a diamond cache where it remembers whether you've attained that already. So like if yeah, there's 100 diamonds, there's 80 diamonds, there's 120 diamonds, there's all these caches hidden in secret places throughout the world, and then it remembers if you've gotten them already. Whoa. Does Zelda have wallets? Let's test out the 20 diamond now, and then we'll switch it back to the other one, and then we'll put these new diamonds in some cool places. Yeah. So the caches are good just to remember, you know, because otherwise, you know, if you don't remember that a player got the 100 already, they could easily just be at maximum diamonds and with an exploit really fast. Whereas this way, it's more interesting. If a player gets rewarded for their efforts finding secrets, you know, by finding these big old diamond caches, just like you do in the regular Zelda, where if you know all the places to bomb, you can find some diamonds pretty fast. Right, yeah, Zelda did have that, but Zelda 1 didn't. For now, I guess I could add that. Are you talking about adding it to Songbringer? Because right now it caps all your diamonds at 255, and that's just totally an homage to Zelda 1. So essentially, you have a wallet that can only hold 255 diamonds in this game right now. I guess I could add a wallet that you can hold more. That would probably be interesting. Yeah, so those diamonds definitely do not look distinct enough. Does it cost money to upload a game to Steam? Yeah, you have to pay your a fee first. Yeah, like Lime Studio says, yeah. Okay, so going back to regular diamonds there. And now we can go place the 10 diamonds and the 20 diamonds in special places. And also, I want them to look better. We all know that number, right? Hope you all know that number. These people that don't know the significance of 255. What? What? Yep, one bite. One bite. All right, cool. We're back to the other diamonds. Now, okay, there's a reward item. You can get reward items, create reward. Where is that? Create reward item somewhere? Oh, here it is. Area creation, create reward item. So reward items are things where you beat all the enemies on a screen and it gives you a reward. Here's where it chooses one at random. From the possible. Yeah, so you might get a bomb, you might get a cactus, you might get a 10, and you might get a 20. All from defeating all the enemies on a screen. Okay, so first thing I want to make it so it always gives you only the 10. All right, let's find an area which would have these rewards. Here's one. Yeah. There we go. We got a 10 diamond reward from fighting those guys. Okay, next thing, I want these to look better. Right now they're too white. And I like the suggestion earlier about making them a little bit of a different shape so that people Anyone that's colorblind can still understand. Okay, let's get out the graphics tablet. Let's do this right. What? That's weird. Times 30. Anyone here from Scotland? Yeah, Scottish pizza is, right? Right, Scottish pizza? All right, we'll start with the diamond 10. And I'm gonna draw. This diamond slice actually might be good. Draw a little palette first. What? That always makes me wonder, you know, when a piece of hardware that's supposed to be designed, you know, well, does stuff like that. It's like, really? Who designed this? Maybe something like that. Right? Okay, the secret to making these look right is making them semi-transparent. Yeah. I didn't want to use a color replace tool here because I wanted to draw it from scratch, kind of. Yeah, anyone that doesn't understand. Okay, I think this is ready to try. Try this red one first. Fast, faster, fastest. Totally. If it's a designer doing it right, why not? All right, so here we got a slice now. Make this thing a layer-based slice. And then hide it. This thing is the HUD diamond, HUD, oh, item diamond 10. Okay, time to check this thing out. It's a different shape for a different echelon of diamond item. Fasterest. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, I'm the only reason you go on Twitch. Nice. Right on. That's cool. I'm happy to be that. Oh yeah, that looks okay, kinda. It looks a little messed up though. The top is weird. But yeah, it's a definitely a distinct shape. So the only thing that looked weird was the top, and those just need a little more transparency. Put that to 50%, go down. Oops. Whoops. Oh, damn it. I hate Photoshop's undo. It undoes the state of all your tools, too. Ugh. There are other people on Twitch. God damn it. Just did it again. I'm like, undo, and then it undoes too much. All right, so that looks kind of too transparent, but once you put it in the game, it actually, transparency is a delicate thing. Do you? What do you dream when you dream about streaming? Your voice started giving out. What? Are you streaming all day? Okay, that needs a little bit more taken off the top. You dream of electronic sheep? The effort and the effort. It's true. Yeah. I wish this was easier, actually. Especially coding. Coding and live streaming is really hard. Art's easier. It's easier to do art, for me at least. Music's cool, but my shit crashes all the time when I try and make music on the stream live. I'll try that again one of these days. I'm sure by now things have. I'm totally sure Apple's fixed all the bugs in their OS and Ableton works perfectly. With game show running. Not singing. Yeah, I don't think I actually even have tried Ableton with Game Show yet. I think I tried opening it one time while Game Show was open, and it crashed. So that's why I'm kind of like tentative on it. But I should. I mean, it's fun. It's like one of my favorite things to do is make music. So for anybody that's watching the stream, though, I do have some music that I made for this game that's on. It's up on YouTube, so yes, you can learn to make music. It's really easy, man. Time of 20. What? You ate peppermint bark? What's up, Cedric? Blood. Nobody knows. It's like the same people that designed your movie player thing. Your VOD player also designed Twitch's chat filtering. Song we should have Sing Ultimate. What's that? Is that like karaoke or something? Right. Just change the hue now. Yeah, yesterday I definitely was, man. I was here at exactly the same time as today, yesterday. The indie thing went great, Cedric. Yeah, it went really great, man. I got a lot of great direct feedback from watching people play the game in person. And I almost won the $10,000, and I did get picked as the audience choice. So Songbringer did really well at the Indie Cup, and it was a very good learning experience. Cool, pizza. Every orifice of my body smells like peppermint. You actually smelled? Grubuck, what's up, Grubuck? He can have the ability to sing song using found guitar. Yeah, there's going to be a guitar item. Oh, crazy. You're awake for 72 hours? What? What? All right, let's make this sucker green. Unless anybody's got a better suggestion for this one. I'm open to making it not green. Alright, that's good. I think we're ready to export now and try these out. New look. Thanks for the follow, by the way. Cream in tribute to my beauty. Oh, yes. The Gibson Les Paul cream. Ah, yeah. Dale, it's definitely going to be a Gibson shape for sure. Yeah, that green one looks really, really enticing. What is that? Yeah. Cool. Green ones. We got green ones and red ones. Let's see which one we get. You can also get notifications with the app, too. If you have a phone, you can get push notifications. Yeah, I like the red one. It's cool. Okay, let's see what happens. Let's turn it back to how it was, where it's got a random chance to do bombs if you have bombs, cactus, diamond 10, or diamond 20 for every one of these reward screens. Then I'll die soon. Don't die, man. Don't die. Stay alive. This week's already had too much not staying alive. You know that song, Staying Alive? Listen to that. Listen to it right now. Staying alive. Staying alive. Staying alive. Record for the longest time spent awake. Whoa. Problems with eyesight? Well, it's various. No way. Wow. He stayed awake for 11 days? That's amazing. Oh, yeah, it is. I think he did mix up sleep and water. What song? Oh, Staying Alive. Oh, the Staying Alive song, of course. Standard D tuning. I love D tuning. I'm the same way on low amounts of sleep. I get aggravated easier. Okay, all in all, I'm liking this. I'm not gonna run around too much longer and try and find other reward items because we already verified it's working. Yeah, we're good. Okay, that's it. Sweet, we got green, we got 10 diamonds and 20 diamonds now. New diamond types are done. Let me check this stuff in. We got a violin, nice. Whoa, nice guitar, Pedro. Yeah. Looks powerful. You barely sleep at all? Yeah. What can you do with all those diamonds? Buy stuff. They're stores. What's up, custom player? Alright, cool. We got 10 diamonds, 20 diamonds, 5 diamonds, 1 diamonds. That was a very short amount of code to add, but I love it. Git commit. Git push. Bam. All right. So, what's next? How much time do we got left? Couple minutes? 10 minutes? Let's see if we can get something else done in 10 minutes. How about lens follow at breaks after walking upstairs? That could be a really easy fix. Yeah, let's do that. So if I put the player inside something, maybe even just the downstairs for the sword. Whoa. Thanks, custom player. Again, let's turn that off. I don't need to do that every single time. Sword boss already defeated. You prefer your classical? Sweet, you can play classical to guitar. Are you really good at it? Man, I'm jealous. I love classical guitar. Whoa. Oh yeah, look, it does work. So even just going upstairs once completely removes the follow effect. Okay, so this shouldn't be too hard to fix. One thing also I want to do, set that to 1 there. So when does it create the lens follow? Lens follow. Push effect, new lens follow. This happens when you very first create the scene. Yeah, here in game scene, create scene. thanks, Cedric. Cheers, man. What program am I using? Custom players. It's called Xcode. It's an IDE. It's an integrated development environment, which means it has an editor for editing my code, a debugger for debugging my code, and a compiler for compiling my code, and a linker for linking the compiled code together. It's got everything, man. It's got stuff you can design interfaces as well and stuff like that. Xcode's pretty cool, but you don't need to use Xcode. You can also, there's plenty of other compilers and IDEs and stuff out there you can use that are totally free. Xcode's free as well. Whoa, cool. Yeah, right. Cool, man. Because life. Yeah, I'm the same way right now. I haven't played guitar in a year, so I need to get my dexterity back. Because I want to put some sweet licks in this game. Okay, so it pushes this lens follow effect, and I think the lens wander dies as well. So something in lens deletes, I think it deletes all the effects somewhere. There's probably a function that does that. Let's go to lens.h. Private, public, animate, reset, camera, maybe, push effect, clear all, I bet you it's clear all, or clear forever effects, either one of these. Oh yeah, clear all and clear, okay, let's see which one it's calling, set a breakpoint there. Okay, so I'm here. I'm inside this little cave. I'm wandering around. The camera is following the player a little bit. Camera's wandering a little bit. It's a nice effect. If I go up these stairs, it all stops because it calls clear all. So phase fade in, begin calls clear all, which deletes all effects that are going. This should probably be clear forever effects. Let me see if that's right. So clear all deletes every single effect. And then resets the render texture. Yeah, and then clear forever effects just deletes things if they're Wait, why would I want to delete either of those? Man, yeah, why does it even do that? All right, man. See you live. Whoa. All right, man. See ya. Yeah, I'm trying to remember why I did this. Why is this? It calls lens clear all from phase fade-ins begin, but why? Why do we need to clear all? Oh, I remember. I remember now. There was, it clears the render texture. It's meant to just clear the render texture. Yeah. All it really needs to clear is the render texture, not this clear all. So let's see if there's, let's see if there's a method in here which would just clear. Oh yeah, we have clear render texture. But is that private? Let's see. Lens. Oh no, yeah, we can clear the render texture, no problem. Okay, that's all we need. Oh, I want to check one more thing. Anywhere else that might be calling this? Nice guitar. Wow. Yeah, that's beautiful. Yeah, nice boogie. Yeah, I agree, Blood, totally. Yeah, I could do Git history. No, I'm pretty sure I remember what it was. It was this area where I was warping from the end of a dungeon back to the beginning of a dungeon, and it was leaving some of the effects on the screen. And all I really need to do is clear the All I really need to do is just clear the render texture. Okay, so I should test this. I should use the goal. Yeah, actually, let's totally test this all out right now. Yeah, okay, good. So we got this one little place to test, and I know where to go to test this. Let's go to the end of the level one. Here's level one. I want to go into the goal room, which is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3, 7, 1. 3, 7, 1. You've been making it for like 2 days without your start menu. Windows minus minus, I would too. Oh, this little world didn't work. Why is that? Yeah, then Minesweeper. Depth remove IE. Zach Wild. Ooh, that's beautiful. It didn't like 3, 7, 1. Why is that? Wait a minute, did the world change or did it just generate two worlds? One, two, three, one, two, three, four, five, six. See, if I learn to count one of these days, it's really gonna help. So you can be a developer and not even know how to count. We just proved that. It's fine. Counting, schmounting. Okay, so there's this effect going on, right? The screen's all crazy. And I think when I'm about to use this teleport thing, it's gonna do a screen effect where things get all crazy looking. And then when I get back to the other area, there should be some kind of visual glitch. There's totally not. There's something to do with that. Whoops. Not exactly sure. I guess I'm gonna put a question mark here and just clear the render texture. Sweet, that's pretty nice looking too. All right, almost done with the stream here. Yeah, that looks like it fixed it. Let's see. Let's go back to that one area, negative 10. And we'll go upstairs, and we should still have the lens follow and the lens wander effect going on. So I'm here. Yep, lens wander, lens follow, looking good. Walk upstairs. Yeah, good. We still have the lens moving around effects. Okay. Good. Another bug fixed. And that's it for today's stream. Alright. Another one bites the dust. Yes. Alright, you guys. So, yeah. I'll be back tomorrow. Dang, Grubuck's got a sweet guitar too. Ooh, nice loot. It's cool. Yeah, I'll be back later, guys. I'm always back tomorrow. So I stream like 5 days a week, 6-7 days a week sometimes. So I'll be back. So yeah, see you guys. Have a good night. $127 bucks, yeah. It's totally what it's like.